go straight into it then. No more hanging around. Velocity are our blue team and will start on attack. And the defending squad, Astral, as our orange team, defense. I don't think it's going to surprise anyone if we see them start in the basement as their first option.
Right.
But this is the matchup that we said they've been waiting for, we've been waiting for, and there's a very real possibility they have something hidden up their sleeve. We saw in EU today one team using that tower location as their defense. We've never before seen it in a pro game. They tried it today. It got very
almost
close,
worked.
But
almost
it didn't
worked.
Quite work for them. Now, it is the turn of North America, and Astral starting things off, as we know, sticking with that laundry supply room down in the basement as their first defense location, and no crazy operators mixed in here too. Just on attack, however,
IQ.
Yeah, on attack, Velocity are bringing out IQ, which again, we saw it today from Mythic in that, from Makoto reported in the first game here for North America. Didn't have the greatest success, but also isn't the biggest surprise. Lots of people using her for their love of her weapons.
And it is worth noting that Astral definitely has arguably some of the best individual players as far as aiming and all that goes. So bringing one person with just the better guns might not be the worst idea.
No, these 1v1 combats can be very, very important. They're then still playing Smoke, those of you that didn't see earlier on. This is, of course, 2.3. This is the most recent patch that came out yesterday. And by all accounts, it hasn't really changed a whole lot. Smoke's weapon, the SMG-11 and Sledge's, arguably, is still incredibly powerful, and they're still playing Smoke in the same way they were before, because
right.
He can still be executed just as well as before using that SMG-11 ACO combo. Frost, very much the same thing again. We have heard rumors that she's not going to be used on all situations she was before, but on the basement here, that shotgun can still be incredibly game-changing.
I mean,
and the traps are still powerful.
The 1014 is not a bad shotgun at all. The Super 90 being brought to the same level as it is certainly not going to do permanent damage to Frost. Just brings her more in line with the rest of the operators.
And the final change, Buck. Reload. Haven't seen him yet, but I have been told that in some of these situations it may happen. Lemel, though, opens up the killing with that first one onto Zed. As Twitch is making her way up here into two sets of crosshairs. Sov's there right underneath his ACOG, and on his right, Frost. Delycan is hiding around the corner. It's going to come down to a very explosive fight in a moment. With Zed off the table, that's one Roma gone. Delycan gives away his position by making a bigger hole in the wall here. BC will spray at him, but not do too much damage. But it pushes him into Dardy's crosshairs, and Dardy takes Delycan out. Now Sov's in the other room, will answer onto Throwdax, but that's his position given away, and now Twitch is going to try and close in on him. They've got him pinned from a couple of angles. Dardy is in through a window as well. Lamel now is going to be the drone for them. They are starting the firefight. Flashbang's going in. IQ looking for the trade across. Sprints over, downs him. Sovs is finished off by Sergeant Jamdar. They've only taken half of their round timer to do this, and that's killed three players. So a lot of roamers there for Astral, but none of them really helping each other out. They're all picked off one at a time and singly. And now only two defenders left in the basement to hold these bomb sites against four attacking members of Velocity. Droning down the back stairs. And here is the all-important trapdoor being opened up then by the Lamel Dardy combo.
Time to
make sure he gets it in the right spot. Gets straight off and triggers it out. Jamdar now here with the ACOG on IQ. And a drone down to check through the holes first. Make sure he finds out exactly where people are sitting. Twitch looking to push down the backside. And again, covering the second trapdoor being blown by Dardy. Smoke's going out from Lamel. Actually, all being killed by Trophy System first up. Third one will work. Flashbang's down the corridor as well. Exec holding very tight on that B bomb site. Amethyst starts the firefight as IQ comes down and hides in the corner. Neither are landing too much significant damage on the other. Drone still checking it out. Sees IQ moving again but can't land the shot. Looks for a more closer engagement and loses out. Down goes Rook. Sergeant Jamjar picks up that kill. Exec picking up one on his own though. BC is down. Now he's got three to find and they're all on pretty low health, so it's not the biggest task. But he has to get them all. Jamjar trading across his face, takes him down to low health. Cannot finish him off. Goes prone and holds position for the defuser. Starts to make himself a hole. Not got the time to make one big enough to get through though. Checking he's not being flanked. He's not, but they're all still in here. One on the stairs, two on the stairs. Does try to get himself up, but that was a mountain to climb, and Lamel will secure the kill. And round number one heads over to Velocity with a convincing attack.
Very, very strong start for Velocity.
The momentum.
That is the key. We mentioned how this meta right now is Roma central.
Yes.
The players that are not on that bomb site win and lose rounds, whether it be getting multiple kills or whether it just be wasting 2 to 2.5 minutes worth of time. They can win or lose the game.
Right.
This situation for Astral, they had 3 roamers outside the bomb site, and they were all dead within a minute and a half.
Oh yeah, and they were close enough to back each other up, but really didn't at all.
Yeah.
So I mean, it should have been a 4-3 or 5-3,
attackers,
but it ended up being a 5-1.
Yeah. 30 seconds for roamer is not a good trade.
Yeah.
When you've spent that much on it, and as a result, the last 2 men could not hold that basement to save their life. Let's see if Velocity either send as many roamers out. More importantly, if they do, will they do a better job? If they send less roamers out, will they still be able to get as much use out of them? There's the key. Sending 2 roamers out and getting a minute and a half out of them is not a bad trade. If
right.
They both die. If you send 2 out and they spend a minute and a half and then come back to the bomb sites, still very good trade. But if they get anything less, then they're starting to have issues of their own.
5 seconds left.
So we'll wait and watch. As the drones are all set up from Astral, making sure they get good vision on various important locations of the map as the prep phase ends, and see if they can find any of these roamers early on and track them down quickly. Lamel then is so far 1 of 2. He's upstairs in the armory. BC is upstairs in the far end of the corridor. So they are within touching distance of each other after a short run, but they're not in direct support. Lamel opening up a nice little fallback position in that main bedroom. And is closing the spaces in which they have to move around and locking off some of the flank positions that Astral could be using against him.
Attackers recovered the bomb diffuser.
Ultimately, they have their locations been uncovered by Astral. So far, no. They're going in on the lower levels, not really worrying about the upsides too much at all. They are still droning around. Sov's using that recruit shield for the mobility. Will lead the charge up these stairs now with Ash in tow. Gonna have suspicions for people who are up here, and now they'll know for sure as BC fires some shots off across his head. Ash is here with him. BC kills Delikon's Ash, but Sovs will answer by trading out onto BC. Using Ash in exchange for the blitz is not too bad, but he's already used up a minute 15 of their time. As Zed takes down Throdex, but Throdex immediately, in fact, they trade each other. Headshot to headshot, and that is 2 players down, 3-3. And that is huge. Lamel, the final roamer that wasn't caught out, gets aggressive, takes down Amethyst, and that's the Thermite dead. That's the trapdoor in the main lobby completely locked off. And this smoke that he placed earlier means Sovs couldn't chase him down the stairs and get him in the back. They cannot now reopen this trapdoor. And with only 2 players left to go on this attack, Astral have to find 3 and get down the very tight staircase. Sergeant Jamjar then will be looking at the angle, looking for the first man to come down. It's going to be a shield, but he's got to get through the barbed wire first, and he's got Dardy there as support. Lamel coming around from behind them and up top. Sovs looking down the stairs. Here comes Lamel inside, go for the spray down, down's 1. Can't get the second, we'll throw a smoke straight out, and it is going to be the shield chasing him down. Goes for the melee, gets the stumble, gets the kill, and with the Astral downed exec, Lamel gets last 2 right on the round ending. Really nice flank from him, and once again, we are showing the importance of a successful roamer.
Right.
Lamel was not hunted properly. He was given free roam, and with a successful timing and backstab, ends
and
that round.
It's not often you see a preset smoke grenade actually do much, but that was perfect. Perfect way to isolate the shield from being able to back him up and get rid of Thermite, disappear, come back just in time to kill them all over again.
So, first 2 rounds on the board in favor of Velocity.
Looks like they're tired of being on the bottom.
Yeah,
we're close to it.
Say, you look at the standing, and I think everyone would have given this to Astral, but they are by no means in their rhythm yet. Velocity getting those first 2 on the board. As you mentioned, really do not want to stay at the bottom of the table this week.
Right.
Want to go for all 3 points.
Good. If you're going to make a comeback, might as well be on the top team, right?
It is. So, thing to note though, this is Velocity's map choice.
True.
So you would expect them to be able to perform a little bit better from here off
you
the bat.
You would.
But this is North America.
North America PC, so you'd actually expect them to lose, I guess.
They have started to shake that trend over the last couple of weeks, but you're right.
Yeah, right.
Number 1 was not that long ago, and everyone that chose a map lost on the map.
Yeah.
So that has got to be fresh in some people's mind. Definitely fresh in yours.
Just got a good laugh out of it.
Yeah, 100%. Astral then not switching up their defense this time over, leaving 3 people upstairs just like before, and putting them all out and about and roaming. Sobs misses that first shot as someone runs across, but does get the twitch drone afterwards. And the second one to follow it. Zed has actually gone back and a little bit closer to his teammates for the downstairs defense this time. So they are leaving these two a bit more spread out to Lycan and Sovs as a pair. But once again, they are very, very spread from each other. And whereas before they could have backed each other up but chose not to, here they couldn't even if they wanted to. Now right. Sovs will rejoin upstairs and be able to back Dalaiken up should he start drawing attention he does not want. Velocity using up 40 seconds their time, still actually very slowly clearing the far end and that north tower. But they are starting to try and make their way inside, and Jamjar running this IQ again with the AUG. Does a lot of damage output. Takes a bit of time to master the recoil, but if you're good with it, as he appears to be, you can win firefights fairly convincingly.
Hasn't let him down yet.
No. So, the Lycan pulling open a couple of windows, giving himself some other angles, and watching the doors below him. Sovs still very close by, also firing down through the floor. That should give him sight onto the trap door that Thermite will eventually be looking to attack, but he's exposed here to the meeting hall while doing it, so it has to be very careful from both angles. Where is the Thermite? Anywhere near it? Not yet. Jamjar upstairs now, pushing in to the location where both of these players are. He's going to have his suspicions, but will not know for sure, and they're going to know he's here now that he shot that camera. So, flashbang into the meeting tunnel. Looks for the peek in. Sees nothing, but there is still a player in there. Goes in towards the armory, and Dalaiken will finish him off. Let's look at Sov's perspective. I can't get there fast enough, as they have snuck straight past him. Another flashbang comes in. He goes pro again. Grenade comes in. This time it does a little bit of damage, but not enough to down him. And he will be shot from the floor underneath by Throdax. Really, really nice play then by Velocity to shift him out of there. But Dalaiken is still up and standing and has dropped down through the floor after breaking that window and is into the garage underneath after successfully picking up one kill. Much better roam play here from the Astral team. Down to 45 seconds is all Velocity have to get down into the basement, and there's still a roamer to be cautious of. BC has realized he must be in the garage and is starting to put pressure onto it. Going to peek in while he's looking the other way. Does get the kill. Do have to down poor little Throdax, but they can get him back up again pretty quickly afterwards. 26 seconds though, three members still alive for Astral. Twitch is pushing from the backside in construction. In fact, Ash is pushing into B, and she's managed to sneak past Exec here, but he will come back around the corner and find her. With Amethyst's help, they'll put her down. FPSZ in there on the stairwell, gets killed by a man that drops through the trap door. 8 seconds on the clock, and Dardy here with the diffuser is starting to plant it. Exec's going for another fight, takes out two very quickly, just got to find Dardy, sees him in the corner, and he cannot pull his fingers off that diffuser. Exec picks up three to clutch the first round for Astral.
Very heavy clutch by Exec there.
Those two players dropping through that trap door in the last seconds together, lining up for him, and he sprays them both down, and there is nothing that Dardy can do but wait for his fate to be sealed.
One player dropping is risky. Two players dropping at the same time just seems foolish.
Yeah. So, first round on the board then for Astral, and they are now back to attack. Kitchen dining hall, first time we're seeing this today, despite this being many, many rounds here on Oregon already. But it's not the first time we're seeing this map, this bomb site selected completely. Previous rounds, it has been won and lost. Using, why don't you go the same way? There we go. I pushed left and it went right. Using these two wooden walls that Throdax is reinforcing there. They have made or broken rounds on this map. People pushing in through those walls once they've been broken. And again. People pushing through this door as well. Allows for smoke coverage in this entire room. And easy plants up this end. But again, there are lots of windows and lots of nooks and crannies for rumors to hide in and to backstab you. So if you do not clear them out quickly and efficiently, it could all go horribly wrong for your attacking squad. That and all that knowledge I've dropped is very widely well known. So I'm sure one of these squads, presumably Velocity, have something up their sleeves as they are the guys that picked it. They're going to know that's the Astral game plan. They're going to suspect that's what they want to do. Should be ready for it in some way. First grenade comes in through the window here from Sovs. No, in fact, it wasn't from Sovs, but they have got the down onto Dardy already.
Dardy wasn't ready for it.
No, locked here in the shower. Is put down. Is revived though by smoke, but it makes him use that smoke charge very early on. And fall back. The Lycan still outside now with Sovs still at the window. Amethyst has taken half of his health and damage as well, but they're still a little bit cautious about getting inside now. So open a couple of windows. Dardy is still inside here with the heartbeat sensor. As he throws from the next window, Brock just gets his shield back up in time to hide from Dardy's shotgun. Dardy's going to peek across the gap, makes the sprint out of there, and survives. And now Thermite is blowing open these walls. So, Sobs. Again, nice and crouched. Avoids a lot of the damage from BC, but has a grenade. Going to throw it straight in onto the bomb. It'll blow up above BC's head, not do a whole lot of damage to him. But Lamel has been taken down by DeLycan on the other side of the map. Lots of very low health members of Velocity inside here now. Dardy taking a bit more of a poke. BC is incredibly low and hiding behind these bomb sites. Will go for the spray onto the shield again. It all bumped into his face. And when he prones, his legs stick out. And he is finished off by Soft's pistol and Astral's assault rifle. Into the corner he gets. The plant starts to go down. There is the smokes. There are the grenades coming in from Amethyst. Dardy will stand up into Amethyst's rifle again. They do trade. Jamdar pushes forward, but is down from another backside cover from Exec here on the stairs, and it's suddenly on all Throdax. He's got to find four, and as soon as he comes around the corner, Exec is there waiting for him.
He found him.
And round number two on the board for Astral. They're definitely in their stride now, feeling it. And two rounds on the trot will level us out. Two rounds to two. We have a report from game number one off stream for us. Orbit versus Gotham Gaming. Orbit won map number one, 5-2. That map was Hereford Base. And Orbit won map number two, 5-1. That was Canal. So, Orbit grabbing themselves 3 points out of that matchup. And again, we'll show you where they stand with the result of this one at the end of this game, which has just taken a turn for the exciting. Two rounds to two. And it's Astral's turn to defend this very bomb site. They just picked it apart for the Velocity defense. Are they going to have a better time defending it themselves? We're about to find out. Forcing that same wall. It wasn't held very tightly there by Velocity at all. It was blown open with ease. Admittedly, yes, it is not a very, very easy one to hold, but it is also not the toughest in the world. And that is going to be a key thing here. DeLycan blows the hole underneath, goes straight up.
5 seconds to the wrong room.
To the wrong
room. He'll get there.
Does see a drone coming in and has to go and track it down first. And we'll set a trap up here to cover his backside. He knows now if they shoot those, he'll hear them coming. If they stand in it, you'll get even more from it. And now opens himself up another escape route around the side. But the hole he made with the C4 will allow him to shoot down on top of whoever may be trying to use that spot to plant him. Lamel opens up the kill on Zed, who stuck his head out of a very aggressive window somewhere. I'm not expecting this player to be doing this. In fact, no, Lamel gets inside so fast, and he goes straight into the bombsite as well. He gets onto Exec, will lose his life, but the damage has been done.
I would say worth it.
Two players down. DeLycan's now pinned upstairs and is being crushed in on. Amethyst downstairs locked in the kitchen. And Sovs is also miles away from the objective. Where is the diffuser? It's on Dardy. He's still locked outside. So Lamel went in very much on his own, did damage, but Velocity are not here ready to capitalize on it. So Astral may have grabbed a bit of breathing room. DeLycan looking to go outside and drop down behind them. Will, I think, just have been detected and is. So they find him, they shoot him down on the stairs. He's finished off. Two defenders left up then. One in the kitchen, one in the stairs to the top floor where he's about to get company. Holding one angle. Dardy behind there would have seen him. BC's pushing in from the main lobby, and Sovs has decided he's going to try and focus his attention on there. Amethyst is also watching BC, so no one's watching behind yet. As soon as Amethyst turns down, he takes off Throdak's head. That was a beautiful shot. Twitch drone comes out from the corner, doesn't spot Sovs, goes in towards Amethyst. And we'll get in towards the A-bomb site. Dardy's still being very cautious with the diffuser. BC still on his drone, and Sovs has not decided to go hunting for him. I think the smarter play here, considering they're all already players down. Twitch drone has now found Amethyst and is covering Dardy with that plant. He's in the corner and hiding around one side. Drone is still being a nuisance here for Amethyst. He cannot find it. It's taken four shots at him now, finally killed off, but the diffuser is down and time has been wasted. Sovs went to find BC, but she gets out and then shoots him in the back as he tries to chase it, and Amethyst now has three people surrounding him. BC with the aggressive push in, shoots him in the back.
I feel for Velocity that the Twitch drone, little R2-D2 there, was the MVP, covering the plant, allowing the bomb to go down.
Yep. Amethyst could not move an inch, and he was already down to basically half health before he even killed off that drone.
Trying to find a stupid little remote control car.
I am amazed and slightly disgusted at Lamel's play there, to be fair. to get in that fast and get those two kills should never have happened from Astral's perspective.
It's one
and
of
it seemed to have even caught his team off guard because they were not even there to support him or ready to back it up or use the advantage he gave them. He got two kills and then died. And they were great.
Yep.
We're just going to go back to playing the round the way we were going to because we weren't ready for that.
Right. It's one of those... certainly not something I would expect to see him do for the rest of the match or the next match, but I feel like every once in a while you make one of those quick little blitz rush plays like that and they can pay off.
That one certainly did. Velocity get themselves back in the lead. 3-2 then, and now they head down towards the basement for their next defense round. Playing the same operators again, reinforcing all the same spots. That is starting to become well known, but playing around these reinforcements is what's changing up from team to team. Dardy stayed very, very passive in this basement last time over and was kind of killed off before he could make any kind of impact. So we'll see if that is the same or if he has a better round here.
5 seconds left before insertion.
As Astral have been doing a great job of defending and cleaning out the upper floors, which, as we mentioned, is crucial to these rounds. Velocity still doing their last few setups, creating many, many different murder holes. Too many spots for Astral to spot out and pre-fire. But once again, Velocity have two players upstairs. Lamel on the middle floor will find the shield. Can't finish him off though. Sovs gets away from it, and now he's got to fall back to BC's position, both of them going straight up the stairs.
Gotta work out that throwing arm.
So, knowledge of these locations has been spotted by Astral. They've now got to try and close in on them, or at least play around knowing where they are and leave someone watching their back. Here comes Lamel then instead. He did so much damage from here in the earlier rounds. Picking up the second round from it, BC now watching towards Sovs as he's coming up this stairwell. Eyes in towards the right. Turns his back to the wall, which they are. Doesn't realize this. Delikin is here to back them up now. He's going to clear out this little corner and give Delikin the all clear to get inside the room. And now Delikin will be able to back him up. So, in a moment, Sovs will push him away from this edge. Delikin will be able to come in. Lamel though takes out Exec now. Exec had a couple of big rounds already, but he's been taken off the board. Down goes BC after dropping down to try and join in with Lamel's firefight. They've downed him, but they haven't finished him off completely. Now, Amethyst is going to spot him and the grenade will finish him as well. Sovs is still upstairs, sorry, down back stairs. And he's looking to make a way in. Zed has picked up one kill onto BC. And now they're pushing in. The grenade comes down. That was a team kill. Amethyst throwing that in there to try and kill the barbed wire. Ends up landing at Sovs' feet. Zed has been downed up top and Amethyst is now the last man on his own. Somehow Velocity, which started off as a little bit shaky with BC dying so fast and Lamel getting crazy aggressive, have the man advantage. He's got more than enough time, so he has decided to come back and pick Zed up. But Lamel is still here on the floor now, watching this top of the stairwell. And with this SMG 11, could mow them down if they're not careful about the directions they push in. Zed, using the sledge, will come through into this little storage room, and Lamel's going to hunt for him. But Zed was ready. And he gets
and the
sledge kill.
Sledge kill.
I was expecting the self there.
Yeah.
I really was.
That was the opportunity, if ever there was a chance. Zed,
I mean, they didn't really have the time, and I can understand exactly why he didn't. He would have been incredibly silly and would have made his team very mad. But,
but isn't that what he does? Isn't that?
That is definitely what he does. But here they go, 26 seconds, they're coming down the stairs. Zed first, while Amethyst is watching the trapdoor above, but Amethyst has the diffuser, so he has to make his way down the stairs as well. Zed drops in towards the corner and hides, get up on top of the dishwasher, or washing machine rather. Astrodex comes into the corridor, takes a tag from Zed, but it's not enough. Amethyst is in the corner and the plant is going down, but Zed's been finished and that allows them to rush straight out. Amethyst gets sliced by Dardy. Velocity then, 4-2. Did have a shaky couple, but they are back into their stride and holding tight. The key thing I feel that Astral's attacks are not utilizing is that top-down trapdoor.
Right. No, they open it up. For no reason. They opened it up and they abandoned it.
Opening up there was great. Sledge could have then got downstairs and actually planted.
Right.
Why Thermite didn't just drop the diffuser for him and let him take it and instead came down there with him, I don't know. They blew it up and then never used it.
Right. I mean, they would have had no problem covering the hallway had they stayed up there.
Mm-hmm. Like, yes, they are losing a lot of players very early on, so they cannot do it the same way we see teams earlier. All five are just holding around this hall, basically, and firing down through it. When you've got more than one ally, someone can stay up top and the other one can go down. So yes, the Roma's velocity and good drop, but I still think Astral could be using that better than they currently are.
For sure. I mean, to be fair, Velocity did the same thing when they dropped down two people at the same time.
True.
Instead of just leaving one up there. Not only did they not utilize it, but they also immediately died.
Yes, exactly. Drop straight into Exec's crosshairs, who is having a great game here for Astral being their sub player. But it's not enough to bring out the even rounds. Four rounds to two, match point then for Velocity. Lamel, you're going to be a crazy aggressive player again. We'll find out. Zed's on the stairs. Oh, he sees him at the last second. Lamel with a quick flick down to Zed. Will also just about miss Sov diving down into the basement. Could have been even worse for Astral losing two players so fast. Lamel sprinting into these objectives really is casting Astral off guard. They are not ready for a player playing so quick.
I would argue he's been far more aggressive than Zed, who we usually see as by far the most aggressive player.
So Zed being where he was, I think he's the guy that pulled this front lobby door open.
Right.
Which is a risky play in its own right, but it also could scare the attackers into it. And Lamel says, I'm not scared of this. I'm just going to push it and use the open door. And that's the right thing to do. Catches Zed off guard. That is just an educated guess, though, because Zed was the closest to it. Don't know who left that open. If it wasn't Zed, I'm sure he's pretty mad at them now. And Sovs went all the way down through the basement and up to the backside tower. Exec then holding the construction tunnels. Amethyst checking the cameras for them. We'll see these guys are upstairs and we'll give that information to his squad. Zedlycan here is at the bottom of the tower holding Sev's back. So, ultimately very spread out from Astral, but they will be in great positions to gather the info of the attacking squads. And Velocity are casually clearing out all the top floors. Lamel now holds the diffuser. We'll clear out all these barbed wires. Dardy is blowing open this trapdoor. Can they actually use it properly this time? Covering the back stairs then is Twitch and Dardy. Now as Dardy's going to go and bow this other trapdoor here in the corner. There we go. With Twitch to cover him. And thankfully this time around, Lamel is using that trapdoor. Throwing flashbangs in, throwing smokes in to cover and get as much info as they can as Delycan takes down Dardy. But Dardy's done his job with those thermite charges. Keeping the diffuser in the same place. Lamel dropped the diffuser, is now looking to come down and in. Gets himself inside thanks to the smokes. Could be planting the diffuser right now. Finally catches a glimpse of Amethyst through the wall. But Exec is straight there to get him back up again. And now the diffuser is going down. So 4v4, a lot of players left alive with this diffuser still on the table. 45 seconds now, and the first man goes down. Exec now comes around the corner and tries to get Lamel, but he will get a second kill. And BC gets the third from up top. Sovs is the last man to die. And BC will finish off Delycan as he pushes through the meeting hall and take the map for Velocity, five rounds to two.
That was a much better attack for Velocity there.
Yeah.
Finally played the top, used their smokes well, managed to not down. I don't think they knew that they initially downed Rook.
I don't think so, no.
But didn't matter.
12-4. Lamel had
a huge game.
And he's going to feature in our highlight clips quite a lot, I suspect. We'll see that in a minute. But yeah, as you mentioned, Astral were playing a good game to avoid being taken out by that trapdoor. They were playing a long way back to make sure they couldn't be seen from it. Mm-hmm. But as a result, with those quick smoke placements and flashbangs that that Ash threw in, they could get in and get control of the plant location, get that diffuser down way quicker than we've ever seen anyone before. 50 seconds left on the clock with that diffuser going down is fastest plant I think we've ever seen.
Might be.
Yeah.
And then their ability to just dice up
Astral then, like, the strength of that bombsite being such few pathways in, suddenly switched back in there. So now they're the ones that have to attack, and as you saw, sprinting into Lamel's crosshairs, giving him even more kills.
Exactly.
Which will now show up here in our highlight clips, I'm sure. And securing the round for Velocity right at the end there in a very quick, sweeping fashion.
Yeah.
And yeah, he's so just playing non-stop aggression. I don't think it's going to work if he continues it onto the second map.
It's going to be a lot more difficult in Canal, depending on how well he knows the map. I mean, clearly they picked Oregon correctly. So if they're well-trained on Canal too, then might still give Astro a run for their money. I'm sure they're pretty happy right now.
Yep, so let's have a look at these highlights exactly and see where all these kills came out and exactly how Lamel picked up the fantastic score he wanted.
Lamel with that stun and knife.
As the teams are switching over and the maps are switching over as well, so we are just about ready to get back into the game as soon as this is wrapped up. But there are some fantastic shots. Here was Exec picking up his clutch of the round. Help with Amethyst to grab that one out, but then he comes in, grabs these two as a clutch, and they can go and finish Dardy off while he's in the middle of a plant, and that did get Astral back on the right track. It did get them two rounds to their name, but after getting those two, they couldn't keep it back up again. velocity adjusted, velocity figured out what was going wrong and what was going right, and came straight back with even more rounds their name. This really didn't help for Astral either.
Especially given how hard of a time Velocity was having dealing with the shield.
Yep.
To accidentally team kill the shield was no favor for Astral there.
It's also a shame because those were two solid players on the roster. Like, if it was the subs, right, that could make sense.
Exactly.
If it was the new guys that are doing that,
but
it
that
happens.
Was a clear miscommunication.
Yeah, those guys have been on the same team.
Hey,
the
I'm cooking
time.
A grenade. I'm going to take out the... Never mind.
I'll take out the barbed wire too, but you're going with it.
Yeah. Not a good trade.
So, teams are ready. Amethyst and and the Astral Squad are our blue team, our attacking team first. Velocity, Willoughby are our defending team. We're onto Canal, and we are underway with map number 2. Think this is going to be as one-sided?
I do not. I do not think it'll be as one-sided. I think, maybe one-sided for Astral. I think this is going to be a lot harder for Velocity to come out on top.
All right. We'll see how that unfolds. As you mentioned, this is the Astral pick. This is why they should be more confident and feeling on here. Solves is taking that recruit shield again. But Lamel's aggression, Lamel's successful roams from that last map, should they follow him here, will ruin Astral's day on Canal.
I have a feeling Zed can roam a little bit better on this map. He's
proven
twice in the Pro League that Oregon is just not really his map. He never seems to do a whole lot of damage on that map.
That is true. He even opted in this last round, the last couple of rounds, to stay within the objective and to stay downstairs.
Right.
Which is very unlike Zed, sitting near the objective, near the bombs themselves. And yeah, as you say, really didn't have a huge impact, which we've seen him have before.
ATS deployed and ready to go.
Where are these setups going on? How many people are they sending, and where are they sending them? Using just kill holes between the two bomb sites here on Velocity, not using any C4 or anything like that. And of course, we'll now make a hole here underneath BC's position, underneath that bandit hole, to make sure they can try and keep him as safe as possible. And reinforcing this trapdoor, which is an interesting option, does keep him a little bit safer from attacks underneath. But we've also seen teams using it as an escape for him, so he can drop down through there should his battery trick fail.
He's committed.
Thermite make it work.
He's not going to run.
But Delikan is who they're watching for. Delikan is the guy they're expecting to come underneath him and try and catch him by surprise. We'll see whether it works. Lamel then with a risky smoke charge on that door. If that's where he punches, it will break the charge before he gets to use it. But he is holding the basement. And it is the direction Delikan was looking to come inside with his war pistol.
Deploying drone.
Sops, using the drone, has spotted Pulse here inside the kitchen. Dardy
deploying
has no idea they know where he is. Lamel still holding downstairs. Zed is on his way in. Sops is close by as well, but is just sprinting past. Zed looking straight up into the map room through a hole in the floor he has made. He's looking for Dardy to come back from the kitchen, and Sobs, wow, shuts him down as soon as he drops his shield. BC though takes down Exec on the other side of the map, so it is a one-for-one trade in different locations as Lamel sets his charge off to cover the basement and sets that one off right on top of Sobs' head. But Zed has followed him in, and Zed gets a lot of damage off onto Lamel here, and they've pinned him into the lower staircase. Comes back up to try and smoke Zed out. Zed will put him down, and we have started to see the kills you predicted rolling in here for FPSZ. Another sledge one in this situation, and we're down to 3 defending Velocity members up here on the top floor now then. BC, Sergeant Jamjar, and Throwdax holding down the fort. Sobs, with his shield right outside this window, will not face too much of an issue of shots running his way. BC here cannot hold off the Thermite as it's already blown open. Sobs broken open another window. Looking to come in and help out through here. Well, over the top, go and fetch the diffuser. I suspect it'll come back his way. That was a fantastic shot from BC, straight through the tiny gap here, through this doorway to the window. Looks for Zed, aims a bit higher, but swings down through and will find Zed all the same. Suddenly, the numbers advantage that Astral had has vanished because Zelikan and Sobs were on the other building while the other two started to push in and get aggressive. That is not a good team.
Yeah, no teamwork there.
When Sobs is running to the other building to pick up the diffuser, you do not start sticking your head into windows. out through the window goes Throwdex, doesn't get the kill onto Sobs. Sobs will knife him down for it, but is stuck in some barbed wire for his troubles. Goes for the plant, has to hold it for 5 seconds. Jamjar will slaughter him from the far side. Did not have time to come off of that diffuser. And Astral take a first loss of this map.
I didn't expect Astral to lose there, but you said it. As soon as he went back for the diffuser and half of them were playing one side, half of them playing the other, there was just no more teamwork whatsoever. They were just totally split.
They were in a 4v3 situation. It was great. And then Sovs goes, right, I'm going to get the diffuser and bring it back. Delight can come with me to back me up. And the other two went, you know what, guys? We feel like dying now. So we're going to push in
when it's
basically 3v2. And, oh, crap, they shot us. Damn, guys, now you've got to play 3v2 as well. I wish there was a better way we could have done this. Like, maybe we could have had the man advantage, but it was the only way. It's the only way. We had to do this. And, ultimately it results in them losing the round. So, not an ideal start for Astral. Zed. Picking up the bandit. Looking for the clutch plays. Using these batteries to destroy the thermite charges. Giving him an opportunity to save the day.
And as we've seen, Zed is pretty good with that bandit plant.
Yes, that has pulled off some incredible feats with these batteries. He's giving himself a nice kill hole down on the side as well towards this corridor, which they've also filled with barbed wire to make it very, very hard for anyone to walk down that yellow brick road.
5 seconds remaining.
But he's still got to survive what could be a push from underneath from an aggressive as hell Lamel. Or from elsewhere. As Thermite tries to plant these charges, so.
Aggressive as hell, Lamel. Was more of a tongue switcher than I thought it was going to be.
You thought this job was easy.
Aggressive as hell, Lamel. So. There it is. That was the trophy I was talking about. You see it on the table? That's
Tekdal's trophy. Tekdal's trophy. Throwdex finds Sovs on the other side of the building. Neither of them landing too much damage as that window gets open, but now they know Sovs is here, and that's going to make his movement in this red brick building a little bit tougher. So they're going to come and hunt for him. Amethyst on the camera as well, feeding information as someone comes down the stairs. And that someone could be BC. He has now been seen, I'm sure. His feet would have just passed it. Amethyst is going to keep feeding the intro. Jamdar would have also just made himself known now. And now the camera comes out. So Sovs has lost his feed of information. But he knows there's at least two people in this building with him. Starts making a mess just for the sake of it. Looks back the other way. He's been droned out. He's in a world of pain right now as here it comes, crushing him from both sides. BC and Jamjar, and now Dardy's joined the party, locking him here in the Coast Guard office. Jamjar comes through, does start pre-firing onto him. Jamjar wins the headshot battle. Down goes Sovs. Does do a lot of damage to Jamjar, but it's not enough to take him down or get the kill. So here we go. Velocity now free to push the other building as they know he's the only roamer there and they've got a minute and a half left to go. Good throw through the window, Lamel.
Excellent
Gets
toss.
Gets that drone in.
Guy thinks he's Tom Brady.
I don't think you can deflate drones.
Oh, there it is.
Dardy, with that thermite charge here, free to do it. They've droned it. They know that Zed has run away. There's no bandit on that far side. And he will get both walls wide open. Zed now holding the angle on the inside, making sure they can't push too far in. Anyone rushes into this corridor, which BC is about to do. He should get the kill, but can't land the shots and has to hide. Goes for a re-peek, but Dardy's already killed Amethyst down the back of the server room, so he has to come and watch this angle as well now. And suddenly Velocity is swarming all over these entrances. 5v3, BC's on the corner again. Zed gets him this time, looks for the diffuser, and he's going to be there. Finds Dardy mid-diffuse, get two key kills. The Lycan now is underneath and we have to hold that diffuser in position as Exec is holding the other end. Gets a tag onto Throwdex and puts him down on his ass. And comes the Wizard of the Mel through the window. But Astral is there. Exec.
Completely
what the hell happened?
Turned around by Zed's pick.
Oh, Exec downed Lamel despite being killed by
him. Yes.
And because they were the last two, they were both down, both killed, and Exec rounds it off for Astral to get their first round on the board.
Yeah, he managed to down but not out both of them.
Yes.
While getting down but not out himself.
I saw Lamel get down, but not. I didn't thought there was one more.
Right.
There wasn't. So those two were the last ones they needed. Exec clutches it, downs one, switches to the next one, downs him two. And that is the round secured by the two of them.
Once again, I thought just as we kind of thought Astral was going to win the first round, I thought Velocity had that for sure, and just collapsed with Zed's two headshots there.
Yeah, they're getting very aggressive again, but as we mentioned before, he is that all-or-nothing player. It's go big or go home, and this time he went big, and they got the round, picking up those two important kills. Dardy did not expect BC to die when he did, thought he was going to have his back covered and could get the plant down. That was not the case. So, down into the kitchen and the projector room is the Velocity defense for their round number two. And they are, of course, sending players upstairs to reinforce these trap doors. They can be very, very powerful when attacking underneath. But, of course, the floors there in that server room location are still wooden. They can still be blown open, and we can still get a lot of vertical play here. So they're going to need to leave people upstairs to defend against that. BC, looking to be the only man in that position right now. They normally send two. But he is the lone army unless Lamel goes up to join him here after picking up his armor. We'll wait and see where he chooses to go. Jamjar then also very close by despite having that longer range weapon. And they will start checking the drones again. The Lycan then spawning in at construction. We'll start opening up windows and locking down the movement inside from Velocity. Once those are opened up, they cannot move so freely around the map. Sovs has got very quickly hit into the garage underneath them all. Zed starts making holes in the floor above, and we'll be using these to watch the doorways and again limit the movement of Velocity within this map room. Suddenly, Velocity got to be very careful of everywhere they go, and it only took 45 seconds for Astral to put this hold on them. No one from Velocity moving much at all. BC here in the server room holding a tiny, tiny angle as Zed grenades himself.
So that go big or go home, it looks like he'll be
go home
heading home
round.
Today. Yeah. Heading home for this round.
Lamel has gone upstairs to join BC, so now they're both watching this top floor. Zed, how you manage that, I don't know.
I really wish we saw it.
But Dardy can hear Sovs coming in, goes for the C4, but there's a grenade coming his way. He gets the C4 kill, doesn't
and
die to the grenade.
Doesn't get touched by the grenade.
And this is looking great for Velocity. Delican using the hole that Zed built to try and see someone, but there's no one to look for. Amethyst trying to get peeks in through some windows, but again, there's no one really there at all. Amel getting a bit mobile, but Exec's still on the other building. And they are now feeling confident enough to hunt them down and to limit them even more. That sucks. Amethyst spends ages checking those windows, ages droning around, finally feels confident enough to go for the thermite plant.
Just to get shot clean in the back.
Clean in the back by Lamel. Dardy finding another player down in the same location he got that C4 kill. And it was Delican picking up the diffuser. Doesn't do any damage to him though. Delican just picks it up and runs away. But cannot get close to the plants. 50 seconds on the clock, and Exec and Delican are in complete opposite ends of the map right now. Delican pushing in, he's going to look for Dardy. Can't land the shot, but now the shotgun's going to come out for him. And that's kind of the predictable result as Dardy now looks for Exec, tags him, finishes him, and Dardy more or less single-handedly takes that round for
that
Velocity.
That was, big plays by Dottie that round. Dodging the grenade, getting the C4 kill, and just wreaking havoc on them so far from the bomb site, even.
Well, it's very nice of Astral to serve themselves up to him on a silver platter as well.
Right, one at a time against the guy who can see through walls.
Guy who can see through walls with a shotgun in a nice tight space.
Right.
Let's go nice and slow for him.
A little angled hallway is not the place to be one at a time trying to take out Pulse. Yeah.
But then again, nothing to take away from Dardy. We have seen players screw that up in what seem to be free one-at-a-time kills, but somehow they don't land the shots and they get taken out. He landed the shots, he made it count, he gets the round on the board, and Velocity take the lead once again. Two rounds to one. Into the Coast Guard office and holding cell goes the Astral defense. Been a while since we've seen these bomb sites used. I think the last time we did was on Xbox and we saw a Tachanka pick.
Yep.
And that is not the case here today. Using the same operators again that they defended the other side with. And holding down very standard positions. Holding this holding room is going to be very, very important to this map. I suspect we won't see too much action towards the A bomb site at all, but the B bomb site will get a lot of focus simply for its ease of defense once the diffuser has been planted.
Right.
But getting in there is going to be no easy feat for the attacking Velocity squad. So, Throdex, using a route I don't think anyone has ever run on this map before. Off of spawn. peas onto the roof. Misses that one in the window.
Just throwing it all.
Yeah, throws him straight in, and wow, Jamjar looks for the fight inside, thinks the Akung's going to be enough, but Zed says, nope, I'm on the warpath. I'm sick of losing rounds.
I blew myself up, I look like an idiot, it's time to make a comeback.
Yes. And takes Jamjar's face off with just the one shot. So, Sovs, still sticking very close to his team. Amethyst here as well. The Lycan spread out a little bit. Ultimately, Astral are staying very, very tightly packed on this bomb site, despite it being one of the smaller ones that allows for a bit more freedom to roamers. And Velocity are counting on them being mobile, counting on them running around too much and trying to pick them off through the windows. But Velocity, you're not going to get that lucky. Astral are holding in very, very tight and very, very disciplined positions right now. Exec taking the most damage, but most of it's from grenades. And they are still yet to make any true progress inside. Half the round gone. Here's Amethyst with a peek outside. Goes for a re-peek. It's very aggressive onto Throdax and somehow survives. As BC starts repelling up the wall, looking for someone. Goes upside down. That could have been catastrophic. As Amethyst re-peeks outside again. Takes down Lamel. Now he's fighting Dardy through the wall and again will survive with a lot of health left. But the Lycan is taken out by BC now. Just as they go to switch away, down goes Throdax. Sov's peeking out onto him. Dardy now. Get inside briefly, but it's taking so much damage he has to reposition. He's going to come and join BC, who is pinned inside the adjoining office between both bomb sites. Dardy's going to come and try and help him. Zed is very close, he's going to hear him. Opens up the main doorway, looks for a possibility to flank around the outside. Softsobs goes in and takes BC out from his pinned position, and it's all on Dardy now. Comes into the holding room, and Zed's going to come round and put him out of his misery. Astral take round number four, 2-2, and that was a convincing defense for Astral on that bomb site.
Right, that was one of those, as soon as Zed popped him in the face, it was kind of, they fell apart fast after that one. They were not ready to start pushing a man down.
No, it does not feel like Velocity really knew how to break into that bomb site at all, and as soon as they lost a player, it made it even worse for them. And I must admit, very disciplined play from Astral to hold their locations, hold their spots, not get greedy for those kills early on.
And very out of character for him, which I'm sure threw them off.
Yes!
All of a sudden, one of the widest spread teams and maps usually on such a big map to Roman, and they're all right next to each other.
Yeah, exactly. They did get a little bit impatient at the end. They saw them peeking for the kills, but they made it work, which maybe it should say. It was catching Velocity off guard. And something's weird. Why are they not peeking? Something's weird.
Right.
I don't like this. And then they let their guard down,
Roman.
And bang, they're back to peeking! And the kills started to flow in for Astral. But we'll wait and watch. Back up into the server room, control room then, for Velocity's defense. Trying to stay that one round ahead by winning another one here. Hunting down drones. It's important to get off as many of these you can in the prep phase. If you can do without wasting all your setup. Going for all four sides to be reinforced instead of leaving one open, and of course just shooting through the floor to make sure you cannot be flanked by an Ash Breach charge underneath. Delikin not making a move into there this time around. Or, sorry, previously hasn't made a move into there, but it's not to say you can't hear. Sov's going straight into the garage again. Zed choosing a different route after failing horrifically last time. Spray in through a couple of windows, checks behind the server stack itself, and then continues his move on. Sov's repositioning from the garage, and is now looking to make another move inside as Delikin is finished off by Lamel. Elsewhere in the boat room, Sov's now pushing in towards kitchen, and there is a C4 waiting for him. Does take him a little bit low this time, but not finish him off, and the melee comes out for Dardy. But this time, he had support here as well, in the shape of FPSZ, so even if he'd have made Sov stumble, I'm sure Zed would have finished Dardy off. Better play then from Astral, sending support with their shield user this time around. Lamel has fallen back. He is holding underneath where the bandit location is, and he's going to hear the shield getting very, very close to him. Behind him, exact. And be very cautious to where he's going. Now he sees Zed going up the stairs. Did he? Yes, he does. Puts him down. Has to turn and run because he knows the shield is still close. And Sovs has decided to rappel up to the building outside. Jamjar then in the server location. BC realizing that his job is done where it was and has repositioned. to the adjoining room. Throwdax holding down the B bomb site from inside. Oh, and he takes down Amethyst as he's in the middle of a grenade throw. We saw Exec win around from here before. It's now Throwdax's turn to try and do the same, and he's got a two-man advantage for his team to help him out. 4v2 in favor of Velocity. Exec's looking to pick him off. Currently can't land the shots. Sovs here to support him. Has got the defuser. Exec still looking for openings. They are smoking the windows and trying to lock them out for a little while. But Throwdax is doing a lot of the work to keep them pinned. Sovs droning in. You know where Throwdax is? What was that? Oh, that drone was to check for frost traps under the window, perhaps?
Probably.
To do, yeah. In three goes, now he knows it's clear. Gets shot in the side of the head, and now Throwdax will peek out. He's going to hide from that corner. Does see one, takes down Throwdax, but now has to hide from the C4. Cannot do it successfully, but Exec will kill Jamjar before being flanked from the side by Lamel. It was a nice try from the Astral pair. Picked up two, but they needed to find four, and the numbers advantage Velocity had left at the end there does ultimately come out too strong.
Once again, another big round from Lamel, splitting that nice Zed shield combo by the second they split apart, just murdered Zed and ran away.
Yep, and Zed not paying attention to what was underneath him at that time. Gets shot right in the crotch. So, three rounds to two. Velocity not as far ahead this time as they were before, but
also
they are
consistently
winning that round to take them up and then drawing it out and then taking them up again. And it is now on to Astral for defense once again in the server and control room. See all this setup here around the thermitable walls, but ultimately no one really putting too much emphasis on blowing it open as the thermite team. It's been done a couple of times, but only really as an afterthought when they've taken control of elsewhere and it's just a freebie.
Right, it hasn't really been pivotal to any kind of gameplay so far.
A lot of teams will build their entire attack strategy of this bombsite around that location. Neither of these two teams using that at all. This corridor is once again converted
5 seconds remaining
into a hellish trap.
The yellow brick road.
Of razor blades.
I thought only Tachanka could do that.
This window open again. Those open the top of that reinforceable door so we can see anyone that's rappelling and checking the angle. But Velocity are starting to make them move forward. Droning first this time. Lamel has definitely slowed down on this map. There's no crazy sprints in like before. He's still faster than the rest of his team, but he has been droning first this time round. And he's already in on the bottom floor. And he had a couple of drones and then backing up. Sorry, I've got my cameras and then backing up to rejoin his team. No shields on the Velocity attack, but they still have that IQ, which, yes, as you see, Jamjar never using the gadget. It's all for the weapon. Lamel taking a fight on the stairs again and does manage to down Sovs. Gets up there to take him out as well, and now we'll fight the Frost with pistol versus shotgun. Goes for the knife. Funnily enough, it don't work until Lycan gets the kill, but he's chased down the stairs by Jamjar, and in mid-reload, he's finished off by Jamjar, also with a pistol, and suddenly Astral are defending with three players against four. Zed, looking for his aggressive plays to try and even up the numbers, did peek the top of the stairs and just missed Jamjar's head.
Frost would not be my favorite operator to go try to knife.
No, at all. Peeking outside. Amethyst is watching the stairs and giving him that cover. An Exec holding the B-bomb site like he did before. He has clutch rounds from here. With a two-man force, they manage to go and win a 4v2. Can they do so again? Thermite then, coming up against the wall, will encounter a battery, but not on the right wall to begin with, but Zed gets a battery onto one, and gets a battery onto the second.
A bomb has been located.
Quickly demolish Thermite's charges.
Yeah, both Thermite charges gone, very nice, but he then goes to rub salt into the wound, and oh, the spectator mode is bugged, and I have to sit in this view. Salt into the wound kills Thermite off as well. Throwdex then running around upstairs. Thank you, BC and Jamjar, for coming onto the roof as well. Putting everyone on the same floor makes this camera a little bit easier. Up onto the very top goes Throwdex. He's going to come back down here as they now start to push in towards B. Broken flashbang indicator on the screen as well. Zed is watching that tiny corner again. Anyone that comes through this window, Zed is going to fire on. Throdex is actually standing pretty damn close to that location himself as he drones into the back of the room to track down where Exec's positioning is. Exec will now be seen and droned out. Hasn't killed the drone. Astral Zed is making the push forward. Is he going to come out the window? No, he's going to shoot Jam Jar in the back as he pushes in to take down Exec. Comes out to the window to fight Throdex. And up on the opposite side is BC, and Exec takes him out through the behind window. Nice attempt from Velocity to make that flank, but BC took so long to get there that the aggressive play from Zed going outside meant the rest of the team was dead before BC could even get there. Good defense from Astral, turning what looked to be an unlucky round from a 4v3 into a win. Velocity. Defense then, downstairs. Kitchen and projector room once more, and back onto that shield goes Sovs. I've seen mixed results from him on that this time around, but at least he hasn't been team killed yet.
Right. Both teams are definitely very comfortable with their operator choices. They have not changed it for either map, really.
Sovs is jumping on spot. There we go. Now starts to move his drone. Same setup then coming out from Velocity, sending people upstairs to make sure they lock out these trap doors and in control of that top floor before. We saw Lamel heading up there eventually to back BC up, and they had both of them defending this top floor rather successfully. And should the trend follow its route, Velocity will win this round and put themselves onto match point. Can Astral shake that trend?
10 seconds
Sorry,
remaining.
Can they buck that trend?
There it is.
Question. The Lycan with his drone in the basement again. Seen it a couple of times now from him that he'll drone around there and then sprint in and take control of the bottom floor pretty rapidly. We'll see if he does so again. Sovs and Zed sticking very close together, but still yet to see them as the perfect shield sledge combo. We've seen some very, very well executed combos, but as we saw on the last attack round,
well,
wasn't done
now.
So well, and Zed got shot in the back.
The perfect shield sledge combo is blitz, because you blind them and sledge them.
I was talking about like teamwork play, but
right.
Yes.
Well, to be able to successfully hammer an alive person that's blind is pretty good teamwork.
That's true. Here we go. The Lycan in and around already, but here's the window broken just behind him. Notice there's one in that building now, and that shot will come out. Now, normally, Astral, when they hear the call that someone's in that building, they will swarm it and clean it very quickly. Right now, they're just watching the windows. Dardy's in that same spot, and Zed is successfully not killing himself with grenades this time around. Dardy's C4 goes out onto Sovs, doesn't kill him this time over.
A lot of damage.
Does take him very low though. Grenades coming back from Sovs, it's going to land right next to Dardy. Takes him low, but not enough to kill him either, and now both of them are running scared from the other. Still waiting for Dardy to reveal himself, put himself in harm's way. He's just checking on the heartbeat, checking that he's there. Throdex taking a lot of damage through the floor here from Zed that was firing up. Lamel come downstairs now, so it's only BC on the top floor, but to be fair, no pressure from Astral is heading towards that location yet. They are sticking low with their punches. Janjar's come back from the red brick building, goes up the stairs right in front of Sovs, comes back down again, falls Sovs' attention sideways, and actually he manages to sleep past Dardy all the same. Now he's going to hear him as he comes around the corner and through, trying to break that barbed wire, exposes his face to Sergeant Jamjar and will fall down to it. But Zed has picked up one kill in return, so it is still 4v4, but Zed trying to come up the stairs now will be executed by BC from the top down. Jamjar and Dardy then still holding down this top, this middle floor quite tightly. Feeling very comfortable now that two of those players are down and the shield included. The Lycan still trying to shoot up underneath them from the garage, but not having much luck. Amethyst bringing himself in, checks behind him this time. After being shot so cleanly from there before, Delikin starting to take some damage downstairs. Down the stairs comes Jamjar, he's pushing him, and not clean from Jamjar, misses a lot of shots, but the kill is a kill, and Velocity are looking to stay on track, winning this round, making it 4-3. Still got a few to find though, and Exec has something to say about it. He will drop Dardy down. Amethyst though will be answered straight out by Jamjar, still on that stairs, and Exec now has to find three with 15 seconds on the clock. Finds one. Jamjar has pushed up and in, but there's another man on the stairs. He sees him, and they've realized all they've got to do is hide. He's stuck in the barbed wire. He doesn't have the diffuser. Walks across the stairwell and will be shot from inside by Jamjar. Round number 7 takes and taken by Velocity, and they get to match point.
30 seconds left, and you drop the diffuser in the yellow brick road of barbed wire. That is not a good place to have died.
No, that's gonna sting.
He Throdex whiff
says that somebody smells.
The whiff.
As they look to set up what could potentially be the last round of the map. And would, of course, result in a draw and be 1 point for either team. Kind of the result I think most people expected from so evenly matched squads. But Astral, of course, want all three points.
No, this would be... If Velocity takes this one, they get all 3 points.
They won. Astral won first match.
No, they won Oregon. Velocity won
Oregon. Sorry, Velocity won Oregon. Yes, you're right. It's late.
It's all right. It's all right. We forgive you. Do a lot of talking.
Got 4 a.m. again. Time flies when you're having fun.
I thought he was about to open a hole. It's like, please don't do that.
Into the Coast Guard office and the holding room once more goes Astral. They had a good defense here before. 10 seconds left. They need to hold on to it again if they want any hope of getting a point out of this matchup. Velocity swarming that red brick building with their drones and the connector to the other side as well. Bardi's drone was over there, so they know that that is clear. They saw nobody running in that direction. And here comes the camera positioning from execs. Again, spots Lamel being very, very aggressive. In same as he has been every time, he goes straight into the basement. His drone is down here, he knows it's clear, and he's going to use that to gain massive amounts of control onto the underside. Gets there just after Delycan breaks that trap door. Delycan gets out unscathed this time over. Camera has. Ooh, no, it's not been killed. He doesn't want to shoot it to give away his position, but he's now standing in barbed wire. Delycan's at the top of the stairs, but so Sovs, and Sovs didn't hear him in the barbed wire. Lamel gets that first kill and once again tries to run away safely, but Delycan's dropped down through the hole he made.
Downs him.
Downed. Will they have to get Delycan up from this, or are they going to close in on him? Dardy's coming for the secure kill.
And downs
goes for it and gets Amethyst
brutal
down to help him out. Suddenly Velocity are picked up so many kills, and Zed has it all to do. He's got to defend against three attacking players to keep his team in this. He's got 2 minutes to do it. They've got all the time in the world to find him. He sees one on the stairs, gets it. Immediately managed to reposition without being traded out straight away, but Dardy and Sergeant Jamjar, such an awesome name, are looking for him. They smoke and drone. They're trying to find him. They've got the diffuser, and they are taking their time. He's repositioning again, still smoking out many different places to try and pin them into corners while he gets into a better position. He's not at full health. There he sees Dardy go through the gap, but can't land the shot. Sees him go the other way again.
Oh, Dardy.
Dardy prones just in the time. But now he knows which way they're coming. Smokes out again. Sees Jarge and Jamjar on the other side of the bomb. Jamjar gets in. Dardy does it. Takes him down. He's got one to find. He's found two, but he's shot in the back. Oh. Turns around at the wrong second.
So
Jamjar drops him
Zed
down. And Velocity take 3 points from a hard-fought matchup.
Huge, huge game for Velocity.